What time do you call this? You're 3 hours late home.
Take it easy, Trace. It's only 8:45.
Well, there's nothing to eat now, so I hope you ain't hungry.
No, you hope I am hungry. Well, I ain't. I had one of them Cornish pasty ice creams up the pub.
What?
You know, the ones they microwave just long enough so the outside burns your mouth, but the inside stays as cold as polar bear's wobbly bits. Mind you, come to think of it, it tasted a bit like polar bear's wobbly bits.
You are going to be really ill one of these days, the muck you eat.
Get it, will you, Trace? I'm cream crackered.
All right. It's Dorian.
Mm. What are you doing outdoors tonight?
Well, it's not a full moon, is it?
Are you two finished?
No, it's Friday. I thought you always had the family round on a Friday for chicken and aggravation.
Yes, well, that's why I had to get out of the house. Marcus invited his cousin Irving over. God, what a fascist.
Why? Because he didn't put it to the vote before he invited him.
No, not Marcus. Irving. You see, I happened to mention that my next-door neighbour's husbands were both in jail.
Just making small talk, was you?
So, naturally, we got onto penal policy in general. Now, I contended that prison used humanely could offer education, counselling, a chance to take stock.
What, like shoplifters?
But Irving said that all prisoners should be castrated because they were subhuman dross.
Where did he make Mark Chris?
Well, Mark Darrell's not subhuman dross. He just made a mistake.
Yeah, he got caught.
Mind you, he might as well have been castrated.
Your pardon?
Well, this is supposed to be a civilised country. They don't give a monkeys about us wives. In Sweden, in Mexico, even in the Turks and the Caicos Islands, you get your conjugal rights. You're allowed to visit your husband in his cell and, you know, do the business, keep your marriage alive.
How fantastic.
Oh, Dor, you old perv.
No, I have been looking around for a subject to do for my Open University project. I was going to do guilt and the Jewish mother.
Now you can do guilt and the Greek bank robber.
No. Tracy has exposed a far more exciting area.
Do yourself up, Trace.
Long-term imprisonment and sexual deprivation. Yes, that's really gritty and low-life.
Well, Marcus is a low-life grit. You could talk to him about it.
Oh, what's she going to do, ring him on his mobile phone?
She can have my visiting order.
Don't be so stupid, Sharon.
I'm not being stupid. Nobody knows us down Albany, Nick.
I thought your husbands were in Maidstone.
Well, they are normally, but they're entitled to a fortnight's holiday. So I went down to the travel agents, booked up the Isle of Wight. They did want to go to America, but Alcatraz was chock-a-block.
But isn't Albany prison for desperate criminals?
Yes, but they've just been sent there short-term while their wing at Maidstone's being refurbished. They're going to have central heating and ensuite toilets.
They won't be so desperate once they've got their own cars, is they?
How riveting. I can hardly wait for the feature in Country Homes and Interiors.
The point is, if Dorian wants to visit Cyprus's least valuable export, she can get in as easy as saying Mrs. Christaki Achilles Theodopolopoulos. I mean, with her Mediterranean looks, she could pass for a bubble easy.
Bubble?
And if you come on the coach with us, you can interview the other prisoners' wives about their sexual deprivation.
Sharon?
Sharon, how can I ever repay you?
I was hoping you'd ask that. You can pay for our coach tickets.
Sesame seed bun.
Good, honest English nosh.
Chili dogs ain't English. Chili's in South America.
This coach trip is turning out to be a psychosocial goldmine. People are so open and honest.
Well, the fivers you're doling out probably help a bit, Dor.
I never knew people could be this poor. I feel so guilty. These women probably spend less on clothes than I do on a luxury, like makeup.
Don't feel too bad, Dor. For you, makeup ain't a luxury.
Sharon,
Just had this cleaned.
Honestly, how can you even dare to put that in your mouth?
She is going to be so sick. No, when we went on that cruise, I never even had a twinge. Oh!
You'll feel better once you see your Daryl and have a nice cup of prison tea.
Oh, I can't, Shell. Just take me to an undertaker's.
Oh, she must be sick. She won't skip a visit. She was only dying a bit.
Oi, mate! Where's the nearest casualty department?
St Mary's. It's just up the road. You can walk it from here.
I can, but she can't. Come on.
In you get.
Shall I come with?
No, you better go and visit Chris.
If you're sure, Tracy. Sharon, how will I recognise Chris?
Easy. He's the Swansea con whose tongue will start hanging out the moment he clocks you.
The nicest thing you've ever said to me.
Boy. I hope that didn't go all over my upholstery.
No, you're in luck. It went all over me.
Oi, Lady Muck, there's a queue here. Oh, it's all right, I've got an invitation.
Excuse me. Are you Chris Theodopolopoulos?
Depends. Who wants to know?
I'm Dorian, Sharon's neighbour. Could you get us two cups of tea, please? Please.
Oh. Hey, and a couple of Kit Kats and all. What the hell are you doing here? Something happened to Sharon?
No, she's fine. She just didn't want to visit you.
Oh, that's typical. Just been transferred, don't know no one apart from Daryl, and she can't even be bothered to shift her fat ass across the Solent.
No, she did shift her fat... she is on that island, right? I think she just came for the candy floss and the donkey rides.
She's a right bitch. She was like that all the time we was together, mind. So I don't know why it still gets to me, but it does. I just can't help it.
I'm so sorry if I've upset you. Is there any way I can cheer you up?
Yeah. They don't allow conjugal visits in here, though. Especially with someone else's wife. Sorry. Well, I didn't mean to be crude. It's just the way prison gets to you.
I suppose it's an aspect of sexual deprivation.
What? Oh, yeah. Then everything in stir's an aspect of sexual deprivation. What's it to you, if you don't mind me asking?
I'm writing a book called Long-Term Imprisonment and Sexual Deprivation.
Oh, yeah? Gonna have any good pictures in it?
Would you mind very much leaning forward a little? I've got a microphone secreted in here. Now, go on. You were saying it was all an aspect of sexual deprivation.
They run out of Kit Kats, so I, got you a flake instead.
That's so thoughtful of you. Keep the change. You don't have a tissue, do you?
Funny enough, I was going to ask you the same question.
Well, I think what she has is a dose of food poisoning.
I told you should have had the chili dog.
Fortunately, her digestive system managed to get rid of the offending food.
Yeah, very fortunate, eh, Trace?
Plenty of fluids, no food for 24 hours and a day's bed rest, and you'll be as right as rain.
Where am I going to get bed rest? I'm 100 miles from home.
Look, I'll see if I can get somebody to ring round and find you a bed and breakfast for the night, but it won't be easy. But you know it's Cows Week.
What's that? The agricultural show?
No, it's our big yachting regatta.
And they take their cows on the boats with them, do they?
I'll speak to my receptionist.
Come on, mate.
And the crazy thing about it is, all them crimes I did for Sharon. I thought, if I made a better life for us, then our marriage, well, you know...
Well, Sharon claims you started seeing other women before the honeymoon was over.
What? Do I look like the sort of bloke who'd spit on the sanctity of marriage? I mean, my people, the Greek community. We value tradition. No. It was only much later, when I sus Sharon was putting it around, that I was forced to seek solace, you know, in the arms of another woman. Well, women. But, of course, sex isn't everything.
Isn't it? No, of course it isn't.
I mean, when you give your missus a good seeing to, how long does it last? A couple of hours? That ain't the basis for a long-lasting marriage, is it?
It's a start.
But it's not just sex, is it? I mean, it's what's in here, you know? Your heart, your guts. Miss Sharon don't understand.
I do. I know exactly what you mean.
All right. I muck around, tell a few jokes. I'm like a big kid sometimes, like Gazza. Without that streak of self-destructive violence. But inside, I'm sad. And Sharon never saw it. I've been doing these creative writing classes in here, you know, to get it all out of my system.
That's wonderful.
I've even tried my hand at some poetry. I wrote this poem for Sharon, to express my innermost feelings, to say all the things that are so hard to say, you know, in ordinary conversation. Want to hear it?
Please.
Promise you won't laugh. Sometimes I wake up in tears, knowing I'll be in here for years. While you, who once was my young bride, have to suffer on the outside. Do you know how much I love you? Do you know how much I care? Promise me, when I get out, I will find you waiting there with a nice plate of taramasalata. Well, what do you think?
I think it's very touching in its simplicity, Christopher. I'm not sure about the taramasalata line, though.
What, you reckon it would be better with stuffed vine leaves?
Come on, visiting's over. Time's up. Say
goodbye. Well, it's been very nice meeting you.
Well, who knows, we may meet again.
Pardon?
I may need to do more research.
Blimey.
Well, go on, then. Give him a kiss, then you can go home.
Good job we didn't want to room with a sea view, eh? Feeling any better?
A bit. I hope Daryl's all right.
Oh, of course he's all right. They wouldn't dare feed prisoners the sort of crap you can get at motorway cafes. You know, I'll phone the prison to tell him you're a bit Moby Dick and to tell Dorian where we are.
Thanks, Shell.
It's all right. It's only a local call.
I mean, thanks for not reminding me how I went on at you for eating that chili dog.
Well, I thought you'd feel more guilty if I didn't bring it up. If you pardon the expression.
This is the Majestic Hotel. What's majestic about it?
but there's a damp patch on that wall that looks just like King Juan Carlos of Spain.
This hotel is a microcosm of all that is wrong with this godforsaken country as we limp towards the 21st century.
Well, it's Cowes Week, isn't it? It's the only place that's got a vacancy.
I wonder why. Did Mr. and Mrs. Bedbug have to cancel? Sharon.
That reminds me. I could murder a toasted mutton sandwich.
Yes, I'm feeling much better, Dorian. Thank you for asking.
I'm so sorry, Tracy. Well, what was it?
My lunch.
The quiche of death.
Well, you can't possibly sleep in here. Heaven only knows what else you'll pick up.
Nah, Tracy will be all right. She loves her Daryl too much to pick up anything.
All I need is a peaceful night's kip.
Well, I am not sleeping in here.
You don't have to. You can go down the front and chat up a big bloke with a nice big yacht.
That's what you do, is it, Sharon?
If I wasn't tending to my poor sister, yeah.
No wonder you couldn't hang on to your husband.
Hang on to what? Here, hang about. What's that lying merchant been feeding you?
I know that he has a poet's heart. A tortured soul. The eyes of an artist.
Are you sure you stopped at the right table? Yeah, Trace, tell her what a scumbag he was to me.
Look, leave me out of this, I'm ill.
Yes, now you know how I feel whenever I have to look at his ugly bulk.
Well, don't worry, Sharon. You won't have to see him again.
Good. Why not?
Because he's got me now, hasn't he?
What do you mean he's got you now?
You should be pleased. You weren't exactly the best wife a man could have.
And he tried a few.
You refused to live with him in his parents' house. You forced him to lose face and live in a council flat, a problem block.
It weren't a problem block until he moved in.
You constantly tried to undermine his manhood by comparing him to Daryl.
I've never even seen Daryl's.
You always try to laugh off the difficult things, don't you, Sharon? Even when Chris wanted to save your marriage, you had to turn it into a joke.
Our marriage was a joke.
There you go again. But it doesn't matter now. All right, so you're a dismal failure as a wife. It happens.
You what? You cow! I tried for years to make my marriage work. I supported him. I turned two blind eyes while he was nobbing and robbing his way through the Tenants Association. He'd fallen out of love with me long before I'd given him up as a bad job. And now he's trying to use you the way he used me.
Meaning?
He's not stupid, Dor. When you tottered into that visiting room and your 100 quid stilettos, he thought, oi, oi, look at the Tom on that Richard.
Tom? Richard?
Tom. Tomfoolery, jewellery. Richard, Richard the Third, bird, it's obvious.
Oh, I wish I'd done A-level vulgarity like you, Sharon.
What I'm saying is, when Chris clocked you jangling more jewellery than Ron Atkinson, he thought, I'll give her the old tortured Marta Moody. Then she'll be good for a few perks. It'll start with a long, lingering looks with those hurt brown eyes of his. And it'll end up with you smuggling in the old Colombian marching powder. I know him, Dor. Stand on me.
I'd love to, Sharon. But if your analysis is correct, then why has he started dedicating poetry to you?
Him? He wouldn't know poetry if it punched him in the kidneys.
Yes, well, that's where you're wrong. He's attending creative writing classes. This is it, in his own handwriting.
He wrote this.
That's right, Sharon. You see, he is still in love with you, the poor fool.
Sometimes I wake up in tears, knowing I'll be in here for years. Don't believe it.
Sharon?
Sorry, Trace, did I wake you up?
What time is it?
11:30. I went to the pictures.
What'd you say?
Silence of the Lambs. I thought it might cheer me up, you know.
Dorian go with you.
No. I don't know where she flounced off to, and I don't give a toss. Do you know what she said about Chris?
No, I want to go back to sleep.
She reckons, he reckons, that our marriage failed because of me. I mean, I done my best, didn't I?
If you say so, Shal. Though me and Daryl always used to say it takes two to turn a flat into a pigsty.
What do you know? You never used to come to our flat.
I didn't fancy having the injections.
Oh, I see. So you're taking Chris's side now, are you?
No, all I'm saying is you could have made a bit more of an effort. I mean, look at you.
What's wrong with me?
Well, nothing now. You look good. But when you was with Chris, I mean, you did let yourself go a bit, didn't you? I mean, you spent so long in that horrible old pink velour tracksuit, sometimes I thought you had a nasty skin condition. Good night.
Good night. But what about all that lovey-dovey poetry? I mean, what if he really does want to make something of our marriage?
What? A game show? Dorian's all right. Do you reckon she went back to London?
Probably. Unless God answered my prayers and she's been carried out to sea by a freak tidal wave.
Can't wait to see Daryl.
I can't wait to see Chris.
Eh?
I've got to have it out with him, Trace. I've got to find out if he was telling Dorian the truth about how he feels.
Good morning, Tracy. Glad to see you're feeling better.
Where did you get to last night?
I booked into the best hotel on the island. A platinum card opens every door.
What, you turned housebreaker?
I thought everyone was booked up for Cannes Week.
Must be why they made an exception for Dorian.
Sniping at me won't save your marriage, dear. I hope this coffee isn't instant.
Instant? Ours took 15 minutes to get here. Is that a new blouse, Dorian?
Hardly. Where would I find a Versace silk shirt on this quaint, old-fashioned island? No, I always carry a crease-resistant item or two in my handbag in case I have to unexpectedly stay overnight. But, of course, now I've discovered Christopher...
Oh?
Wait, hold up! Hold up! He's still my husband! If he sincerely wants to make things work, if he really has developed this new side to his nature, well, maybe I should give him another chance.
Just a moment. It was to me that he revealed his sensitive secret side, not you. I'm the one that can nurture his potential, buy him books, writing materials, find him a literary agent.
You two have gone raving mad.
Well, I'm going to visit him today, then we'll see.
How are you going to do that? Dorian used your visiting order yesterday.
I've got half a dozen unused ones from Maidstone in my bag. I'll bluff me way in. Easy peasy.
Thank you. Thanks. All right. Think you got the wrong nick, darling. This is Albany, not Maidstone. Maidstone's about 80 miles in that direction.
Ah, I must have got my visiting orders mixed up. He got transferred from Maidstone last week. You know, while they were putting on suite bathrooms in their cells. Please.
Well, I suppose... Hang about. It says here, Mrs. Theodopoulopoulos.
Yeah.
Well, she was here yesterday.
Can't have been.
Yes, she was. A dark haired type with a leopard skin coat, loads of makeup and jewellery.
That was his mum.
Well, the way he was kissing her yesterday, he should be doing time for incest. Now, I don't know what your game is, darling, but you should sling your hook, or I'll call the local fuzz and you'll be receiving prison visits. Right, next. Thank you.
So you mean to say you've been coming here for the past 22 years? Why?
I was doing manual labour on the island for 18 years, and I got to like the place.
18 years? What made you spend 18 years working on the Isle of Wight?
The judge at my murder trial.
Well?
Yeah, he's really settled in well. He's got his own cell with sea view, and the food's a million times better than Maidstone, and the screws are all right and all.
I ain't talking about Daryl.
What about Christopher?
Has he spoken to him?
What does Daryl say about him? Has he told Daryl about me?
Daryl said all Chris can talk about was how fantastic Dorian was and that he's finally realised there's no chance of you two ever getting back together again and he wants Dorian to start visiting regular and maybe a real relationship will develop based on deep mutual respect.
Christopher said that.
Blimey. He must have been going to writing classes.
How could you have doubted him?
Yeah, Daryl and Chris have been going together. Daryl said Chris is really fantastic.
I'm so pleased.
You see, I'm not doing a psychology course for nothing, Sharon. I have innate sensitivity.
And in what way exactly has Christopher been fantastic, Trace?
Well, Daryl wrote me this little poem, but he was too embarrassed to tell me. He was going to keep it secret, but Chris got him to say it over and over again until he learned it by heart sort of thing.
Oh, bless him. Did Daryl tell you his little poem?
He wrote it down for me.
Let's hear it then, eh, Trace?
No way. It's personal.
That's right, Sharon. How can you expect Tracy to share such an intimate message with us?
Daryl shared it with Chris, didn't he? I mean, Chris helped Daryl learn it by heart. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if Chris hadn't learned it by heart and all.
Oh, all right, I'll read it to you. Sometimes I wake up in tears, knowing I'll be in here for years, while you, who once was my young bride, have to suffer on the outside.
When I'm alone.